Tune into this week's Xamarin Show, where I have my good friend Javier on all the way from Spain to show shapes and drawing and all this amazing new stuff in Xamarin forms. So tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show, part two of the brand new Xamarin Forms drawing APIs with shapes and paths and geometry and all that goodness. Now, Javier was getting into all of the awesomeness that you could do on the first part. So if you haven't watched that, check out the show notes below. I'll link to all that stuff there. So let's just hop right back into where he left off for part two, advanced shapes with the brand new Xamarin Forms drawing API.
Then I go probably the most subtle shape, but also is probably the most complex one, and is the path. So to create a path, we have many possibilities. We can use a path have a property data, and data spec a geometry. And with the geometry, we can draw very, very complex stuff. Let me just scroll very quickly, but you can see that we can draw very, very complex stuff. So we can draw things like, hey, I want to use a path geometry. You can create a path geometry with a collection of figures, and then we can create different segments. There are a crazy amount of different segments, like a line segment, but take a look to that, because if I filter by segment, you can use an arc segment, a bezier segment, a poly bezier segment. So yeah, you can combine all these segments to use, join them and create very, very complex stuff. But then we can also have type converter allowing you to use a string. And this is very interesting, because you can directly copy this string from some tools. I'm going to talk about that. Because, for example, you can draw with tools like Inkscape, or there are tools like, for example, SimFusion have a tool with a crazy amount of icons called Metro Studio.
Yeah.
And you can export the icon to a PNG or an image format, but also you can see the code. And do you guess what is the code?
It's just data, probably. Yeah, it's a shape. That's crazy.
It's a page. It's a path with a data. So you can just copy the data and paste the data in your application, and voila, you have a beautiful icon drawing directly by native APIs.
Wow.
So this is simple. This is of, let's see, geometries, using the geometry. This is also a collection of geometries, but in this case, remember that, we can define different review centers, and we can define what will happen with the intersections, and then moving to the most complex ones. Take a look to this here, or the Windows logo. Is use where is the Windows logo? It's here. So the Windows logo, it's a crazy string that, of course, I have not written. I just copy from a tool. But yeah, you can do exactly that. And let me jump to other case. For example, you can, from a SVG. So this is Cartman from South Park. And what I did is I will load a SVG. And let me go to this sample. So take a look to that. This is the SVG. I open it with a text editor. Mm. And if you take a look, the SVG is a combination of different paths with data, and I transform to XAML directly. Wow. Well, I'm using the path and using the data. The rest is the same.
Wow.
The field and most of the properties are the same. And at the end, if I modify stuff, like for example, let's go here and modify this color to red, and we can do that with Hot Reload. We modify the face, the color face, because every element, every point, every combination of character, of Cartman, is defined with one of these paths. And we can do exactly the same with other, combining other stuff. Like, for example, take a look to this clip art man sample. And it's a crazy amount of polygons.
Yeah.
40 polygons. So, yeah, the bass, the noise, the mouse, everything is drawn with a polygon. And wow. But that's fantastic because I can use now apply transformations to every of these polygons or any of these polygons. And yeah, the possibilities are increasing. You know, it's not, this is not just a static image. I'm able to interact and manipulate every of the items that compose this this picture.
Yeah.
So how hard or how crazy could be that? Let's take a look to this sample. It looks like an image, but it's not an image. It's again a crazy amount of paths, but yeah, just combining different paths, we can get very hard and complex shapes. In this case, it's mostly replicating an image, but it's perfectly possible. So after talk about all the basic shapes, let me talk about more possibilities and are the transformation. First of all, we have the aspect property to feel uniform or do nothing about. So this is the original size of the shape, but I fill the shape in a grid with this space. So if I apply the fill property to the aspect, the fill value to the aspect property, the shape will automatically increase and transform their size to fill the parent. And then we have the render transform property. And this is more complex because, let me go to this sample. So in the path, we have the render transform property. Of course, we can only apply a transformation like scale if you only want that. I create a group, and in this group, we can define different kinds of transformations. And take a look to that because we can use rotate, scale, skew, of course.
Oh, wow.
And translate. We are just applying all this transformation directly to the path defined by this data, Windows.
So you don't need to necessarily continuously modify the data, right? You just apply these transforms on top of it, and it takes your data and then does stuff to it, basically.
Yeah.
Cool. That's neat.
So this is more of the possibilities. And then I love this option. We have the clip property. So what we did is include a new property in the visual element. Remember that the visual element in Xamarin Form is a base element. So that means that you can use this property in all. I'm using now the clip property in the image because probably is the most common scenario. But that don't mean that you only could do that with image. You could do that with, I don't know, if you want to do that with, for example, apply a corner radius, clipping the corner radius of an entry. Yeah, it's perfectly possible. So in this case, what I'm doing, let me go to this sample, is we have an image, but for image, you can use the clip property, and then you can use different geometries. You can use an ellipse geometry, but you also can define a line because you draw lines. But what if you draw a line with an effect of a part of an image or some stuff like that? Now it's perfectly possible.
Oh, wow.
And of course, we can just clip using a rectangle, and the most complex is a path. A path is just use whatever you want. But in this ellipse, we can combine ellipses to create more complex stuff, of course, something like that. And then you can use the path to do something like this. At the end, I tried to do something simple here, like a triangle, but it could be as complex as you want. And then it's not something specific to image. Take a look to that. I'm using a stack layout, stacking different levels, and I'm applying this ellipse geometry, setting the position, the initial center, and the radius. We can get some very nice effects that probably for some case, menus and stuff like that is very interesting. So let's go to other sample, and voila, we are using here a button an entry, editor, search bar, different controls. Of course, in this case, not very, very beautiful because we're using very basic colors and a very basic shape. But you can see the potential here. We can just clip whatever you want with the shape that you want.
Yeah, that's awesome. I mean, it's cool just to see that here. It's true. It works on anything, and it's this beautiful little clip property that lets you sort of combine these things together. So while it's a new API, it kind of combines with all of your existing controls, which is really cool.
And we released that in Xamarin Forms 4.7. And well, first of all, this all this sample, if you want to play with exactly this sample, you can download the Chase Playground in my repository, and you can play with all this stuff to just play with clip, basic shapes and complex shapes. And then I maintain also the Xamarin Forms good looking white samples that is user repo with the community creates sometimes some sample using some specific stuff, new stuff, creating very beautiful UIs with Xamarin Forms. And in fact, the last 5-7 samples are using shapes. And if we take a look, for example, to this one, because it's the last one that I included, not for something special, but it's very beautiful. It's a good job from UFOOC. And take a look to that, because there are some stuff that was not possible before. Well, it was possible, but using Skia, for example, the selected tab here is clipping the corners in this way. And of course, that was not possible with the box view or with the frame or any specific Xamarin Forms stuff. You will need to create something custom, a custom renderer, or use Skia or something like that. The same happens with every item, the data template that define every item in this collection views, that again define the same corners, the same clipping, the same corner, this triangle is also a shape. And yeah, we can continue taking a look. For example, the shopping button is exactly again a shape. The borders around the line or some effects are using shapes. And yeah, many people from the community is using this stuff. Again, this one from Altair, also this effect in the background is using a shape. Or for example, sometimes in the GIF appears a background image with a specific shape. Come on, we are waiting for you now. So you can see that we have this image with a cool specific shape that, yeah, you can do that as you want. And it's a new world of possibilities. So I think that, yeah, shapes cover the possibility of create new stuff in the UI that was not possible before. But also, in my opinion, it's very, very interesting to create new controls. And let me change the emulator from the basic shapes to this one. So, for example, this we included the check pause and the ready button that was very requested in Xamarin Forms. And if I remember well, you collaborated with the ready button one. And yep. Looks like the native check pause, right? But it's not the native check pause. What we are doing here is create a new control and take a look to the code. Well, we are creating the check pause in a easy way. So this is the check pause, and we are creating a rectangle that is just for the corner radius. We are using the reduce X and reduce A properties. And then for the indicator that indicate that the check pause is selected, we are using a path with the check indicator. And yeah, creating the control in this way. So it's a totally cross-platform control using drawing API. So we are drawing basically the control, and we are just using a gesture to recognize the tab, and in this case, just updating the background and the check. And the same could be done to create more complex controls. For example, I mentioned before the rating control is a good example, for example, and then we can talk about charts. Chart is an excellent sample to use shapes, and all these charts are just created using shapes. We are not using anything outside of Xamarin Forms, and what we are doing here is use a combination of shapes. For example, the axis, the categories and value axis are used lines, you know, and then the grid lines are again more lines. In this case, for the line chart, we are using just a polyline. For the area chart, we are using a polygon. Because why? Because we are, remember, we are closing the polygon, the last point with the first one, closing it. And for the bar chart that is more complex, we are using a path creating different segments and unions to draw every bar. But yeah, that's perfectly possible, by the way. Hopefully this stuff will be part of the Xamarin Community Toolkit, and yeah, it's perfectly shape is perfect to draw some stuff and create some small parts like this checkbox with the rectangle, with the path, with the indicator and all this stuff, and also to draw more complex stuff, for example charts, a rating control. It's perfect to create new controls too.
I mean, I've been pretty quiet because I've just been letting you show it off. It's amazing. I really can't wait to get in here. I love that, you know, you can take, you know, existing tools and SVGs and existing assets and kind of bring them over. If you had examples, like you said, from WPF, things like that. I think it's so cool. Javier, this is awesome. This is awesome. Thank you so much for showing it all off.
Yo, thank you to invite me. And let me end talking about what's next. With shapes, and we are working hard to include Bruce support in Xamarin Forms. Bruce support will be available in all the views, so you can apply Bruce to any view, you know, any control, the navigation bar, tab bars, and all this stuff. And of course, we will include Bruce support, as you can see in the image. So what will change? We have seen today how we can fill a shape with a specific color, a solid color, but or we can define the border of every shape with, again, another color. But what will happen is that you will be able to use a brush. So you will be able to use linear gradients, radial gradients to define the border or the fill color of the shapes too. So that's what's coming in the future. Near future for Xamarin Forms shapes.
Well, I'll have to have you back on when brushes are all done and have you show them all off, because I think you can do it justice. So that's awesome. Javier, thank you so much for coming on, show us all off. And of course, I will put links to all of the source code, the good looking UI sample, and all the documentation as well. You can also go to aka.ms/XamarinForms-shapes, and it'll take you right to the documentation, and it'll probably be a big bubble right now because Cameron's gonna overlay that aka.ms, and then you'll see where it's at, but it's also down there in the show notes. Javier, thank you so much for coming on, and enjoy your afternoon over there in Spain and the great weather.
Yeah, thank you too much. It was a pleasure, and same for you.
Awesome. Thanks everybody for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that like button, do all the things that you know you want to do right now. Thanks for watching the Xamarin Show, and have a great day. Hey, James here. Just wanted to check in and thank you for watching this video. Now do all the things that you know you want to do, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell. Become part of the notification squad. While you're here, check out all these awesome videos that I've already recorded. Click on that thing. Click it. Watch it. Do it.